Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 13th induction ceremony of the Winthrop High School Athletic Hall of Fame. At this time, I would ask you to rise for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I'd like to introduce Miss Peggy Bailey of the High School Athletic Hall of Fame.
Thank you, Mr. Domenico. Dear Heavenly Father, we offer grateful thanks on this night for this gathering, for your special people whom we will honor here. Michael Arruzioni Jr., Paul Ferrara, Kristen Finn, Robert Flanagan, Paul Gallivan, Nicole Giaquinto, Patrick Gunn, Lewis Hinckley, Joseph Murray, the 1984 State Championship softball team, the 2006 Super Bowl football team. We are grateful for who they are and for the things they have done, for their talents and their abilities and their contributions, and for the pride they have brought to Winthrop High School and to our community. All of tonight's honorees have been a light to our school district, our community, and our world, and we are thankful for them. We ask this in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the Master of Ceremonies for the evening, a graduate of the class of 60 from Winthrop High School, an athlete and a scholar. He's been interested in our athletic programs for as long as I can remember. And for those of you who know how old I am, you know how long that is. But his enthusiasm is difficult to put a blanket on. He's a sports reporter, currently active. If you read the Winthrop Sun transcript, you will find his information in there. I would like at this time to bring to the microphone our MC for the evening, Mr. Jim Lederman, the voice of the Vikings.
Thank you, John. John didn't tell you that in 1997, he was one of four former Winthrop High School graduates that started this Hall of Fame. Does everyone have a program tonight? If you don't, we have extras, but you can refer to it. And on the back, it lists 165 inductees. And I can honestly say that one of the proudest nights of my life was in 1998 when I got inducted. So first, I want to pay tribute to all the hard work that they've done. We've been working on this for about a year. So this is the Hall of Fame committee. Peg Bailey, Howie Conley, Robert Bonnie DiGregorio, John Domenico, Coach Dale Dunbar, Richard Milano, Bill Schmidt, Richard Tebow, Chris Siotis, your Winthrop High School Athletic Hall of Fame committee. We have some very special guests that are with us tonight. Senator Joe Boncory couldn't make it. He sent the chairman of the school committee, Tino Capobianco. He'll be handing out citations from the State House. Also, Council President Ron Vecchi was supposed to be here, and he sends his best. And the first special person that I'm going to introduce is a young lady that was inducted into the Winthrop High School Hall of Fame in 2006, I believe. She's going to be the second two-time Hall of Fame inductee, a great athlete. She's our superintendent of schools, Miss Lisa Howard. As John told you, this is the 13th Winthrop High School Athletic Hall of Fame. If you believe that your team or some individual athlete that you played with is worthy of the Hall of Fame, the next Hall of Fame will be 2020. We're going to do this every 2 years. 2 years ago, approximately, we had 325 inductees in this beautiful auditorium. So there are nomination forms available. Most of the time, it's Chris Siotis, who's a member of our committee, has those in his office. So remember, we have two teams a year. We hope to have more females. We have two outstanding female athletes tonight and two unbelievable state championship teams. Okay, so the first inductee from the Winthrop High School class of 2003, he's the third member of his family, a famous Winthrop athletic family. And let me just point out tonight, this is all about families. The theme tonight should be families. There's so many great families in there. The tradition of this community is families, great athletics, great students who become successful in life. Michael Ruzioni, his uncle Vinny Ruzioni, his dad, Captain Mike, the presenter for Michael Ruzioni is Coach Jimmy Gillis, I'm sorry.
Thanks, Jim. All right, let's get this started. First of all, I want the committee to get nervous. I know I have a lot of cards here, but I just don't see as well as I used to, so I had to really blow up the font. First off, congratulations to the inductees this year. It's another great class getting into the Hall of Fame. I'm honored to present to you tonight Michael Ruzioni Jr. for induction into the Winthrop Athletic Hall of Fame. Michael is the quintessential Winthrop student athlete. He possesses all the qualities of the type of competitor that has helped so many Viking teams succeed over the years. A student athlete of sterling character, as evident by his commitment and dedication to the WINOC program throughout his time here at Winthrop High School. It was his drive and dedication that would have him go from flying down the left wing of Dale Dunbar's Viking hockey team onto the ice of one of the most successful Division I hockey programs in the country, Boston University. Michael's athletic ability allowed him to not only compete in two of the tougher track events, the 400 and the triple jump, it allowed him to thrive. His athletic ability was never more on display than with his unbeaten stretch as a triple jumper, a stretch that would help lead Pat McGee's 2002 team to a conference championship in his junior year, and Michael onto the all-conference team as a senior in 2003. As an undersized fullback for Tony Fusillo's football program, Michael's toughness was always on display. An explosive runner, tenacious blocker, an aggressive tackler, his importance to the success of the team was immeasurable until it became something that was measurable. And we were 4-0 when Michael separated his shoulder his senior year. That team would go on to have a very good year, but not as great a year as it was destined for. With Michael, that team definitely goes on to win the NEC and quite possibly the Super Bowl. And as a coaching staff, we often go back to that year, and to a man, we all agree that Michael's absence had a huge impact on the outcome of that season. When you put these attributes together, it gives you the honor of being the Bentley Swift Award recipient as recognized by the Winthrop High School coaches and administration. It also allows you to earn the total respect of your teammates and coaches, as proven by the fact Mike was elected captain to all three teams that he played on. Michael's character, drive, determination, athletic ability, toughness, and leadership truly made him an athlete for all ages. He would have succeeded on any team in any era in the history of Winthrop athletics. Michael, I truly loved being one of your coaches, but I think I would have loved being one of your teammates more. And with that, I present to you your newest member of the Winthrop High School Athletic Hall of Fame, Michael Ruzioni Jr.
Thank you. Such a nice auditorium. I feel like I'm back in like high school. First, I need to thank the committee. I'm truly honored to stand here before you today with my fellow inductees, to become part of such a prestigious group of local men and women. Special thanks to Dale Dunbar for believing I belonged here and nominating me to the board. Though I never had the privilege to be coached directly by Dale, I have had the pleasure of him yelling at me over and over again in his notorious loud, deep voice while attending his youth player development camps. Huge shout out to Coach Gillis for introducing me a short while ago. I've had memorable coaches over the years, but none more than Coach Gillis. I also need to congratulate my fellow inductees. I didn't play with all of you, but your tales of greatness will linger through the halls of WHS forever. I was lucky to be a part of some really good teams during my tenure at Winthrop High School. We weren't always the biggest or strongest, but we always competed, and that's a testament to the coaches and players. We won games on execution, grit, and will to win. Being a little more talented never hurt either, but you know, there's more of the coaching staff and what the way they were able to coach us and get us through some of those bigger games. Winthrop Athletics taught me pride, perseverance, mental strength, and teamwork. Yet the biggest gift it gave me couldn't be taught on the field or learned in the locker room. It came from my coach's life lessons. I've always had amazing coaches. I played with kids from Florida to California, Texas, all over the state, and very few of them could remember their youth coaches. I remember all of them. The coaches from my youth molded me into the man I've become today. They knew who they are, and they need to be acknowledged for their dedication and hard work. No town has much passion for their teams and players more than us Vikings. Words can't express how important my family has been through the years. I wouldn't have gone anywhere if it wasn't for them, especially my mother. I mean that literally. She drove me everywhere. Life has a lot of moving pieces, but she has always been my rock. Whether it be 5:30 morning hockey games or midnight madness at BU, she was there, always with a smile. My dad's my hero. He's my hero because he's always been there for me, no matter where in the world he was. He showed me how to tie my skates, throw a football, and he taught me to stand up for your family, no matter if they're wrong or right. I need to thank my sister, Leanne, for her fierce personality and her strong will. Thanks to Paul for your strength and courage and always pushing me to be my best. Thanks to my younger cousins for being my punching bags growing up. And always having my back as we got older. I need to thank my Uncle Vinny and Coach Usillo and Coach Rich out there for being the most perfect role models as a kid. My Aunt Jeannie is also here tonight. She's probably my biggest fan. If you ever find yourself watching highlights of the 1996 youth football, hockey football games, that's her running up and down the sidelines. I need to thank my wife, Megan. She didn't know me in high school, but I'm sure she wished she did. If I pass along anything to my growing family, is hopefully a piece of Viking pride. People don't always stay in Winthrop forever, but no matter where you go or who you become, you'll always be a Viking. Thanks.
Okay, the next inductee is from the Winthrop High School class of 1996. When you talk about great athletic families, Paul Ferrara belongs to a family with 10 inductees into the Winthrop High School Athletic Hall of Fame. That's the Ferrara and Martucci family. From one great family, there are 10 members in this prestigious Winthrop High School Hall of Fame. I remember Michael playing football, and I'll always remember the game in Swampscott. As Jimmy just pointed out, we would have won that game. And Swampscott was always our biggest opponent. And as Coach Gillis said, without Michael, we didn't win the game. We wouldn't have won the championship. Winthrop touchdown, scored by number 21, Paul Ferrara. The presenter, another Hall of Fame member, Robert Noonan.
Good evening. Let me first congratulate all the recipients tonight and thank the Hall of Fame committee for putting on such a great event. I have been told to keep my remarks short. I believe Mark D'Ambrosio is speaking tonight, which that's why they're doing this every 2 years now. So, you know, it's great when I look around the room here tonight and see so many great people of our community here to support Winthrop Athletics. We have such a rich tradition. There's so many great past and current coaches here that give up countless hours of their time and dedicate to the student athletes of Winthrop High School. And looking up and seeing, you know, these great teams and athletes and guys that I played with, it makes you feel really proud and privileged to be a part of a great tradition that is Winthrop High School athletics. You know, and I think when you look back, everyone who had the opportunity to play here in Winthrop, you do remember these great moments in time, these great games. But I think the best quality of Winthrop athletics is the friendships that you forge and the teammates that you make. Tonight, I have the distinct honor to induct one of the best teammates I've ever known and one of the best friends I've ever had, and that's Paul Ferrara. What's interesting, though, is that for those of you who know Paul, you'll never hear him say anything about his athletic career. You'll never hear him talk. So what I did is I just did a quick little list of things you'd never hear Paul say, all right? So you'd never hear Paul say, I ran for back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons my junior and senior year. You would never hear him say, I scored double-digit touchdowns as a junior and a senior. You would never hear him say, I was the only starting sophomore on a Super Bowl team. You would never hear him say, I had 70 tackles as a senior and 50 of them were solo. And those of you who play football appreciate that's a tough thing to do. You'd never hear him say that on Thanksgiving Day, he hit the best player on Revere so hard, he's still feeling it today and helped secure a 12-0 shutout for the Vikings. And he probably put one of the best baseball plays that, you know, my recent memory. We had a tie game in the bottom of the ninth in the state championship, and we were in the quarterfinals, and the bases were loaded. And he dropped down a perfect executed suicide squeeze and shocked everybody, including myself, who was on second base, had no idea he was going to do that. Not sure if Coach Finn gave him the sign or he didn't, but it was great. And he basically won every award as a senior in football, including the Irvin P. Alexander Award, the Francis Fiorietti Award, my wife's gonna kill me if I mess up her family name, the Gold Helmet Award, the Ed McFarlane Award, the Thanksgiving Day MVP Award. He was a Daily Item All-Star, an Agganist All-Star, and an NEC All-Star. So now you might ask, why is, you'll never hear Paul say that, because I'm pretty sure if you look over at him right now, he's the most uncomfortable person in this room right now. I'm pretty sure of that. But Paul, I'm here to tell you, you weren't just good, you were great. So you're going to have to deal with it tonight. No surprise, Paul comes from a great Winthrop family, a large, great Winthrop family. I like to say if you played the game of 6 degrees of separation, you'd probably find out you're related to a Ferrara at some point or another. Paul's family, and as Jim said, what a tradition really is in an institution within this town, you know, of great athletes that have come from that family, starting, you know, with his brother Michael, who's an unbelievable athlete here in Winthrop High and in college, his cousins Joey and Chris. One to mention that I wanted to point out on the Hall of Fame is his uncle Stephen, you know, Stephen Adamson. Tremendous football player and family and legacy here. Paul now has his own family, and his beautiful wife Elizabeth is here. Another standout Winthrop athlete. Thinking about a female Winthrop athlete is another one, just a note, 2 years from now. And he has three beautiful kids, Reese, Paul, and Lola. All right? So, listen, I could go on and talk a ton about his statistics and games that he played in, but really, you know, what I tell you, the reason why I think it resonates so much with me is his quality of leadership. Paul never bragged about his accomplishments. It was always about team with Paul. Paul was one of the hardest working players that I've ever played with. He made people around him great. His dedication to team and most importantly, his teammates was nothing short of amazing. This is why so many of us came here tonight. I will tell you, there were teammates that reached out as far as Las Vegas, California, that wish they were here tonight to wish him well, because that's how much he meant to them. If you look around and you ask past players and coaches from Paul's era, I think they would say he's more than deserving of this great honor. Paul is exactly the type of athlete we should be celebrating in our High School Hall of Fame, showing our young athletes of today how to compete the right way. Paul, it is my amazing honor to induct you into the Winthrop High School Hall of Fame.
Thank you, Robert. Good evening, everyone. I'd like to congratulate everybody up here tonight. Also, I would first like to thank the Hall of Fame Committee, for accepting my nomination. A group that volunteers their time for others to have a night like this is truly amazing. Thank you. It is truly an honor for me to be recognized as part of what I consider an elite group, something that I never really considered for myself. So now I would like to thank the people who I believe helped me to achieve this award and are the reasons why I stand here tonight. My mother, from a young age, spent hours with me struggling through what seemed like endless nights of homework, science projects, and book reports, encouraging me never to give up. Thank you. Working with my father every summer, probably since I was 12, taught me what it meant to work hard. I was so lucky to have him there beside me my whole life. Thank you. My sister, who I idolized and looked up to, she was an incredible role model. For me, and even now, teaching me how tough and courageous she is. I'm so incredibly proud of her. Thank you. My little big brother, Mike, who was always a supporter of me, always in my corner and on my side, whether I was right or wrong. And again, now I'm so lucky to be able to work beside him every day. Thank you. This next person was a big reason why I got through high school and probably why I was able to play sports. Lisa Howard, thank you for all that you did, help and support that you gave me. Certainly all my friends and teammates, older and younger, without you this means nothing. This is every bit a piece of yours as it is mine. Thank you. Robert Noonan, I can't put into words how much I appreciate this. I can only hope that someday I get to do something equally as thoughtful for you. Thank you. I have to mention this person because he's probably the most excited person here. We've been through a lot together, and he's a tremendous friend. Albie, thank you. And of course, the man who dedicated a lifetime of coaching, a coach that brought out the best in us and sometimes the worst, but that's what made him the greatest coach. But with his, with his endless amounts of time that he put in, he was able to make average teams good, good teams great, and great teams champions. Coach Fusillo, thank you. And last but not least, my beautiful family, my three kids, Reese, Paul, and Lola. I'm so proud of you guys. Every week, one of you just does something that amazes me. Thank you for being such good kids. Most of the time. And my incredible wife, thank you for all that you do for me. I don't know how you do what you do day to day. You're an amazing mother and a wonderful person. Thank you.
The next inductee from the Winthrop High School class of 2008, Kristen Finn. When you read the program, you can read about her accomplishment, but I remember growing up and reading about Peter Finn, her dad, who's an outstanding administrator, great basketball coach, and I'm sure everyone knows her sister, All-America at Bentley University, and of course, it's her mother who's an outstanding coach in Winthrop. From a great Winthrop athletic family, the presenter for Miss Kristen Finn is the illustrious Miss Winthrop Basketball, a member of the Hall of Fame, Peg Bailey.
Good evening. I want to thank Kristen for asking me to be her presenter, and thank everyone for being here. I have the honor and pleasure of introducing a graduate who is an amazing athlete and person. Her quiet strength in a cross-country race, on the basketball court, on the softball field, and in the classroom set an example for many. Kristen was a three-sport athlete at WHS, excelling in cross-country, basketball, and softball. She was a four-year starter in basketball and softball, captain of the cross-country and softball teams, and co-captain of her basketball team. I have been a part of the basketball program since I was 15, and it was incredible to watch Kristen on the court. Kristen's abilities were recognized beyond our little town, and she was a Boston Globe and Boston Herald All-Scholastic in softball. In her senior year, she was awarded the Wallace B. McLean Award. This award honors an outstanding female athlete who has done the most for athletics in their career at Winthrop High School. After high school, Kristen brought her outstanding student-athlete abilities to Bates College, where she was also a standout athlete. Kristen played basketball and softball. At Bates, Kristen was a four-year starter and captain of the softball team. I had the pleasure of watching her play basketball in Connecticut against Trinity College and watch her pitch at her alma mater at Bates College along with a few games over the years at local schools here in Massachusetts. Congratulations, Kristen. Thank you for making WHS an amazing place to be. Welcome to the Winthrop High School Hall of Fame.
Thank you. I would first like to sincerely thank all of the members of the Hall of Fame committee. It really is an honor to be inducted, especially considering all the deserving athletes of this award. Next, I would like to thank Peg Bailey. She has always been one of my biggest supporters, not only during my high school athletic career, but during my collegiate career as well. I don't think I can emphasize enough the lasting impact that she has had on Winthrop athletics. I will always appreciate everything that she has done for me and for all of women's athletics at Winthrop High School. She deserves it. I would also like to congratulate all of the other accomplished and well-deserving inductees tonight, especially my teammate and longtime friend, Nicole Giaquinto. Her athletic resume is very impressive, from her time at Winthrop High School to her collegiate athletic career at UMass Lowell. I have played with Nicole since I was very young, and I think one of my favorite memories being a Winthrop athlete is the friendships that I formed. As I look back on my career, I really cherish all the bonds and that I formed with all of my teammates. And plus, getting to play alongside my sister Courtney are things that I will always look back and cherish a lot more than any wins or losses. I will also always be indebted to all of the amazing coaches, teachers, and mentors that have had a positive impact on my time at Winthrop High School by pushing me to be a better student athlete. I'd like to thank my cross-country coach, Warren McPhail, my softball coaches, Don Harrington, David Guffey, my basketball coaches, BJ McPhail, Peter Grimes, and of course, Frankie Fabiano, who isn't here tonight, unfortunately. I also would like to thank all of the other amazing coaches and teachers who I'll never be able to thank enough. I also owe a very big thank you to both of my parents for everything that they have done for me throughout my athletic career. They were there to get me to every practice and were there cheering for me at every single game. Their encouragement and support is something that was and still is something that's invaluable to me today. I was so fortunate to be an athlete at Winthrop High School. I really don't think there's any other high school or community out there that supports and invests in their student athletes like Winthrop does. Now that I'm beginning my professional career, I cannot help but look back with appreciation and gratefulness for the way that Winthrop High School not only prepared me for college, but for the next chapters in my life. I am forever proud to be a Winthrop Viking. Thank you very much.
The next inductee from the Winthrop High School class of 1978. Robert Flanagan comes from a family that is dedicated to this great community, many, many years of public service. And when I called Robert to tell him that he got nominated to the Hall of Fame, and I had the great pleasure of calling him to tell him he got voted in. He told me it would be one of the greatest nights of his life because his dad, Charlie, was formally inducted into the Winthrop High School Hall of Fame. I've known Bobby since he was very, very young, and he became not only a great three-sport athlete at Winthrop High School, he went on to Boston College and had a very, very successful collegiate career, and also he became very successful in business. But what I most remember about Bobby is he's a typical Winthrop athlete who became successful and remembers how to give back to this community. So I'll never forget, I can't remember the game or the year, when I first saw the Viking Pride buses, okay? And I think it was at a tournament game when I saw them. And when I heard the story that Bobby Flanagan made those buses possible, it's just typical of a Winthrop athlete who became successful in business, and he didn't forget where he grew up. So it's my pleasure to introduce Robert Flanagan and his beautiful wife, Linda, is the presenter.
So you all know, I have a cold, so bear with me. You all know that my husband, Bob Flanagan, was exceptional in football, basketball, and baseball, and that his talent in these sports earned him this spot in the Hall of Fame. What you don't know is how central athletics have remained in his life. Here's how. After graduating from Winthrop High and Boston College, he moved away from team sports and took up distance running. I can assure you that it's not easy to run regularly when you're working at an all-consuming job on top of a 75-minute commute in and out of New York City. Nor is it simple to include vigorous exercise in your daily routine when you get home and there's a back-to-school night event or orchestra recital to attend. All you parents out there know this. But Bob was determined to stay fit. Many mornings when our kids were little, he would slip out of bed before anyone was up, put on his New Balance trainers, and run for 6 miles. Oftentimes, when he got back, pumped up and sweaty, the moon still hung in the sky. Then he'd shower and get into the office by 6:30. You don't run the Boston Marathon in 2 hours and 59 minutes, like he did, without such dedication. Whenever I'd commend his discipline, he'd say, by way of explanation, anyone can be out of shape. Another way that sports remain integral to Bob's life is his love of play. Let me put it this way. In Bob's world, anything that can be thrown should be. For example, the ends of bananas, the gross part that's often bruised or slightly off. To this day, Bob will eat 95% of his bananas and use the remaining 5% to practice his jump shot into the disposal in the kitchen sink. Thankfully, he has good aim, but he eats a lot of bananas, and stray mushy bits often appear next to the coffee pot or windowsill. I'm reluctant to buy the little prepackaged carrots for the same reason. These vegetables have become surrogate basketballs in our dining area. And whenever an apple ends up in his hand, he'll comment on how its shape and weight is perfect for throwing. Often he's turned to me and asked, apple in hand, "What will you give me if I hit that dogwood behind the neighbor's house?" Finally, Bob has a keen understanding of the intrinsic value of youth sports, which he's tried to pass along to the next generation. These views were shaped by his parents and reinforced by his team experiences at Winthrop High. Bob believes that the shared joy and sacrifice and the lessons in discipline and resilience make athletics invaluable. Sports also have to be fun, or why bother playing? He's always encouraged our children to participate for these reasons, rather than for personal glory or an edge in college admissions. That being said, he also urged our kids to follow their own paths, even when they veered more towards photography or fishing than basketball or soccer. He didn't need our kids to replicate his athletic successes because he understood that his first duty as a father was to love his children and help them identify and nurture their own interests. I want to end with a story that captures Bob's athletic playfulness, which might be the legacy of his sports career and why he deserves this induction into the Hall of Fame. Allow me to set the scene. It was maybe 7 years ago. We were all out to dinner, my entire extended family, maybe 17 of us. at a fancy Italian restaurant for some second-tier holiday. We'd settled into our seats at a long rectangular table, Bob at one end and the kids and their cousins at the other. The water in wine glasses sparkled and long tapered candles gave the table a soft glow. It was peaceful. Then suddenly a wine cork went flying across the table and bounced off our son Jeff's forehead. "Woohoo!" crowed Bob, who chucked that projectile with pinpoint accuracy. I recall my mother frowning, but Bob's joy in his perfect throw, which punctured the solemnity and triggered rounds of laughter, perfectly illustrates his enduring love of sports, which started right here in Winthrop. Congratulations to my husband, Bob, for this much-deserved award.
Love middle age. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for coming tonight. It's been 40 years since I graduated from Winthrop High. What's the best thing that's happened to me in that time? Well, you just heard from her. Thank you, Linda, for those nice words and all your support and inspiration. And for what it's worth, she's a 249 marathoner. We've run a great many times together over the years. I had no choice but to stay fit. Thanks to the rest of my family as well, the New Jersey Flanagans and the Winthrop ones, for helping to make my life's journey the incredibly great ride it has been so far. I'm thankful for this honor for a number of reasons. One is that it helps connect me more to my hometown, which I left many years ago, but which has never left me. I appreciate being in the company of the many athletes superior to me who have helped Viking teams achieve the outsized success of which we are all proud. But for me, the best part of this honor is that it deepens an important family connection. Most of you know of my family's long history of service to this town through the Winthrop Fire Department. I am not part of that, much as I admire it. I didn't follow my father's lead like my brothers have so successfully done. However, Dad is also a member of this Hall of Fame, and he was always my main supporter in any athletic undertaking. I cherish the fact that he and I now share this membership. Now, high school was not the best time of my life. Let's just get that out there. I was a very shy and anxious kid. I may be in the Guinness Book of World Records for the most painful and awkward adolescence of all time. I don't even need to look up to suspect that my brothers are nodding in agreement. By high school, an optimist might have called me a work in progress. And yet, by the time I entered Boston College, I was much more than ready to assimilate nicely and easily to a much bigger environment and move forward at a much faster rate. What happened? With the perspective that time affords, I've come to believe that my involvement in athletics was a big part of that transformation. Even as my lack of confidence in other issues held me back at times in high school sports, my intense involvement in football, basketball, and baseball helped me address and resolve those issues. In a tackling drill, or an important at-bat, or trying to play through an injury, I had to put myself out there more than I was otherwise ready for to confront fears, accept responsibility. Perhaps most importantly, being on a lot of teams gave me many more friends than I would have had just based on my social skills at the time. I sincerely believe that without athletics, I could have gone a lot longer without confronting some of this stuff, which in turn would have lowered the arc of my life. Linda and I often see high school athletics used a different way now, coveted as a vehicle to gain admission to a more prestigious college. Many kids wouldn't consider trying three sports anymore, or even two. They believe that they should specialize in their best sport or the sport with the best path to college. Kids today often favor club teams over their school teams and fancy prep schools over their hometown high school. I don't knock any of this, but I believe the experience that I had with school sports, the growth I was able to achieve through them, and the experience of doing it in my hometown were probably what educators had in mind more than a century ago when athletics was made a part of the school experience. I know it was awfully good for me. In retrospect, I wouldn't change anything about my school athletic experience save for a couple of untimely broken bones. The success I had helped me to believe in myself. The success that eluded me made me hungry to do better. Sports aren't always fair, and there's more than a little pain, figuratively and literally. There are plenty of bad outcomes, and you must learn to deal with them. Sounds like good preparation for adult life, doesn't it? Playing three sports gave me three distinct experiences. I was pretty good in one, decent in another, though Coach DeFelice would likely challenge that, and just good enough to make the team in a third. It was healthy for me to experience being one of the best on a team and also one of the worst. It's another good life lesson to know what it's like to be down when you are up. It leads to something wonderful and in short supply lately. It's called humility. I congratulate those being inducted with me tonight. I remember Lou Hinckley, how high he could jump, and what a great basketball player he was. I've read the bios of the younger inductees, and I'm awed by what you have done. I'm thrilled to be going in with my longtime friend, Paul Gallivan. Paul has supported so many young athletes for decades, and now sets the standard for grace amid difficult circumstances. I'd like to hail the efforts of the Viking Pride Foundation. I appreciate their work to help Winthrop kids of all economic circumstances have the same chance to achieve growth through athletics that I did 40 years ago. Finally, I'd like to thank the members of the Hall of Fame Committee for supporting my candidacy and making tonight a reality for me. I am especially grateful to my good friend Nick Siotis for having had the crazy idea of nominating me. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Robert. The next inductee is not from the Winthrop High School, or graduate from Winthrop High School, but I've known Paul Gallivan for about 40 years. I'll never forget the first time I saw him kick a football. His athletic talents were numerous, and many people say that his kicking ability might have gotten him a chance to play in the National Football League. And I had the thrill to not only watch him play, but Paul and I worked hand in hand many times doing a little bit of landscaping. So he's extremely hardworking, great family man, and as you can read in the program, his talents everyone has seen before, whether they be on Miller Field or on the Larson Rink. He's very talented. He gets the award for exceptional service for what he's done. He made athletes in Winthrop be very, very proud when whether it be a football team that came to town and saw the Viking head on Miller Field or in some of the legendary games in Larson Rink. So Paul Gallivan was a great, great, not only a great athlete, and the man who first coached him needs no introduction. He's not only one of Winthrop's greatest athletes, he's the athletic director at Bentley University, and I had the great pleasure of playing with him 60 years ago. The presenter for Paul Gallivan, Coach Robert DeFelice.
60 years ago, Jim, you're getting old, buddy. First of all, congratulations, obviously, to all of the inductees, and just a quick side note, being a part of this organization, it's great to hear the common theme that has come from all of these young men and women and all the ones in the past, and that's the experience of being an athlete in this town. It's beyond description of the uniqueness, I think, of the community and the people that come out of this community and its loyalty. The one young man that just left is a great example of someone never forgetting from where he came from and still supporting this place. So I just wanted to make a mention of that. It's a great feeling for me to sit back and hear all of that. Paul Gallivan, if you read the bio, he did the ice and he took care of the fields and he was a pretty good athlete. I think it is really not a disservice, but it's very difficult, I think, for a lot of people to understand his commitment and value to this community in those two roles. He was a professional. He skipped being an amateur. He went right away to being a professional, taking care of the rink. It was the finest ice surface. He was, as I would describe, an artist, and did the same thing with the fields. But I think his pride and his real love of this community and the athletes that participated, whether it was in hockey or out on the fields, is what really drove him way over and above what most people would do. He left Winthrop, went over to UMass Boston, went over to Boston College, and excelled in all of those same things, taking care of the rinks, and then started his own business. And I can tell you from my dealings in fields, I would call him many times for his advice. I would say probably in both areas, he's the expert, whether it comes to ice or fields. One great testament to him is probably the last year, I think, that he worked, maybe it was after he got finished, is that we were playing on Thanksgiving Day against Revere, and it was a pretty significant day, and he spent the entire night doing our field, putting the Viking head, painting the field, 1 o'clock in the morning, him and his brother with the car lights on, did the field. It's so out of what was had happened in the past is that day Winthrop won. They had a pretty successful season, and I guarantee you there were more people talking about the spectacular field that we played on. And I think he began and was in the cutting edge of being an artist besides taking care of the field, came from his commitment and hard work ethic. What's not known, only very few people really can relate to this, that he played for me at Christopher Columbus High School 55 years ago. There's not too many survivors from those teams. He has promised me that he would not relate one story at all about his football experience at Columbus. But I will say this about him. He was a three-sport athlete, but he was a great three-sport athlete. And what Jim said about his kicking, he was a professional kicker. He really was. He was a quarterback on the football team, probably one of the better hockey players at Christopher Columbus High School. In those days, they were one of the foremost teams in the state, and he was an all-star pitcher in baseball. So I think the uniqueness of his commitment to this community and what he had done for our athletes and how much he gave, it was also, he was probably as an exceptional an athlete as come out of this town. If you made a list, probably the top 10, maybe we should make it 25, Paul. Top 25 athletes, he's up there in that group. 10 might have been a little bit too tight. So I really feel privileged, I think, to be able to present Paul Galvin as an inductee in the Hall of Fame at the Winthrop Viking Hall of Fame.
Well, good evening. It's nice to come back. Been out of town for about 38 years, but I come back here a lot. I want to thank everybody for coming out, the committee, Howie Connolly for shocking me with the call. You've been inducted. I thought it was another joke from Howie. And the other inductees, I know all about you all. A lot of you know me, some no idea, but some of your parents know me. If they've ever talked that story, hey, the guy with the beard just kicked me off the field. My children were sitting in the audience. When I go to visit my mother at 55 Beach Road for a holiday birthday, I'd always have to drive down South Main Street, take a left, and they'd go, oh no, Dad, you're not going by that field again. I says, I still have the key, 3252. I gotta kick them off. Anyway, I'll make it brief. I love this town. I come back every year. I do whatever they need, if they need something. I brought my kids with me to help me. That story about the night before Thanksgiving game, and we have the lights on literally in the end zone, And my dad, who worked up at the Carbon at East Boston, went and got me a tuna sub, which some of you know, the tuna's a big part of our family, the Gallivans. And he brought it down. And we had a little picnic. And of course, Coach came by too. He wanted to know, what are we doing? I said, well, I'm trying to spell Vikings, and you're bothering me, so go away. And, you know. But everybody loved to come out to our fields. It was like a passion by accident back starting in the early days of a park department summer job. Barry Rosen and I were assigned to come down here to the baseball field, and I've never left. So in conclusion, so the athletes really should have the limelight here. I'm so humbled that you would think enough of me to put me into this Hall of Fame. It's one of the greatest thrills for me. Thank you very much.
You've heard from the presenters and the athletes, and they talked about great teams, great athletes. But here tonight are two All-American athletes who went on to college and achieved greatness. Nicole Giaquinto was one of them, okay? So she played on a basketball team that had many great athletes that went on to captain their college teams. But on that team was Courtney Finn. And she became an All-American basketball player at Bentley University. And Coach DeFelice was very proud. But we were all proud in town when we watched Courtney play for the national championship. So from this great team in 2008, there are two female All-American athletes. What town in the Northeast Conference can match that? So when Nicole Giaquinto played in the Songus Arena, the place was packed. They lost a tough game, but there were so many great athletes. I'll point to Rena Malios. But Nicole went to the University of Lowell, became an All-American in track, and she just represents what this town stands for. Great athletes, great students that make this town so great. The presenter for, Nicole Giaquinto, her track coach, Warren McPhail.
It's my incredible honor tonight to introduce this stage the fastest female athlete ever to walk through the halls of Winthrop High School, Nicole Giaquinto. In my 20 years of coaching, next to coaching my own kids, my experience with Nicole has been the most special in my coaching memory. The first time I met Nicole, she was a gum-chewing, wrist and headband-wearing five-year-old kid. Her dad, Don, convinced me to let her run against 100 or so Parks and Rec runners down in the summer camp on the track. I walked over to the shy little girl, walked her to the starting line, and I said, "Are you ready?" And she looked at me and said, "Yep." I said, "Okay, when I say go, you run." I said, "Go," and she ran, and she beat everybody. She beat everybody by about 10 to 15 yards. I walked her back to her dad, and he looked me right in the eye, and he said, "I told you so." Later in high school, after she gave up softball, where she led the Northeastern Conference in hitting with a .436 average, I think, I had the amazing good fortune of coaching her, and what an experience it was. As a team, we won 6 straight NC championships in cross country and track. And a side note, she never played on a team that didn't win an NC championship. She won 12. Very impressive. Individually, she had the 100 meter record, 12 flat, 200 meter record, 25 flat. Those are two records that probably will never, ever be broken. She was a state champion in the 200 meters. She was a league MVP twice. She was a conference all-star too many times to count. She was a team captain in all three sports, cross country, basketball, and track. She was truly, truly a once in a lifetime athlete to coach. At U Lowell, she went on to have an amazing storybook career. I asked her to give me a list of everything, and it was too long. I would be here for a long time. So she was an All-American. She broke the school record in the 200 meters, 300 meters, and she was on a 4x400 meter relay team that finished in the top 10 in the country. She was a team captain for 2 years. Tonight, I feel so proud, so happy, so honored to be here to welcome her to the Hall of Fame, Nicole G. Quinto.
Thank you. Growing up in Winthrop afforded me the opportunity to have a stimulating and enjoyable youth, and it was because of the phenomenal athletic programs throughout the town. From T-ball and Parks and Rec basketball to track, softball, and soccer, my childhood was filled with endless love for sports. As I got older, I gravitated towards my two favorite sports, track and field and basketball. My parents gave me every opportunity to improve my skills and enrolled me in every team or club they could find. I would not be standing here today without the constant support from my parents. Winthrop Sports has taught me self-discipline, leadership skills, and most importantly, teamwork. I would like to take a moment to recognize a few people who have undoubtedly changed my life through sports. Without them and their impact on my life, I would not be here today standing in front of you. Coach McPhail. I first met Coach McPhail when he became my fifth grade teacher at the Winthrop Middle School. Our classroom had a little basketball hoop on the wall, and I used to play one-on-one basketball against him during our free time in class. I took it way too seriously, and I would run home after school to tell my parents every time I beat him. I'm still not sure whether he was just letting me win or really trying, but he saw the potential in me at a young age and continued to push me to be the best athlete I could be all throughout high school and college. To Mr. Grimes, who used to call me the fastest human and never called me by my real name unless he was really mad at me, thank you for 4 fulfilling years of high school basketball, and thank you for always making me run an extra suicide for the hoop gods. To Peg Bailey and Frankie Fabiano, Winthrop Sports would simply not be the same without you. To the Winthrop community who never failed to produce a massive crowd at all of our schools, games, and meets, your support never went unnoticed. To my teammates, especially my co-captain, Kristen Finn, thank you for lots of laughs and so many special memories to look back on. Finally, I'd like to thank my family for their encouragement and support. If you've ever attended a Winthrop High School, CYO, or River Valley League basketball game, you may have seen my father at half court disputing some close calls with the referees from time to time. My grandfather was never too far behind him, and my mom was somewhere pretending she didn't know who either of them were. My parents have always been my biggest supporters and have traveled to 15 different states to watch me run a race that's over in less than a minute. Mom and Dad, those minutes mean a lifetime to me. To Grandma Phyllis, thank you for always bringing sliced oranges to every college track meet and passing them out to everyone on my team in addition to everyone on the opposing teams. To my brother, as kids, we used to fight constantly. He would destroy my dolls and I would unplug his video games while he was playing and try to run away before he could catch me. Little did I know this was the start of my running career. Thank you for teaching me competitiveness and simply teaching me how to run for my life. To the rest of my family and close friends, to my sister-in-law and boyfriend, thank you for your dedication and always supporting me in every aspect of my life. I'm honored to be a part of the Winthrop Athletic Hall of Fame and can't thank you all enough.
The next inductee from the Winthrop High School class of 2004. When I see the 2004 number and I look around, and so many times tonight the word Viking pride has been spoken about. That was the year when the superintendent of schools in Winthrop ended sports in Winthrop. Okay. I'll tell you this one quick story that I always remember. I was at a restaurant in Swampscott, and this big guy taps me on the corner, cold shoulder, and says, "Are you the voice of the Vikings?" I said, "Yeah." If you remember 2004, Winthrop made the headlines in the Globe, the Herald, Sports Illustrated. No sports would not be in Winthrop anymore. And he was captain of a Swampscott team, and he said, you can't end sports in Winthrop. It's the greatest rivalry. Well, that's the year the Viking Pride Foundation was founded. Two of the chairmen are here tonight, Richard Fusillo and Vinnie Crossman. And I mentioned when we look back, and it's only 14 years ago, we've won Super Bowls, state championships, Northeast Conference titles. And if you read my column many times, I point out the 37 basketball titles, the state championships in football, three Super Bowl teams. This all happened after 2004. So I want to congratulate Rich Fusillo, Vinnie Crossman. No town is prouder, as we mentioned tonight, of their athletes and our accomplishments. And we owe it all to Viking pride. So I've had the thrill of watching so many great Winthrop High hockey teams. I started my career in journalism in 1976. I did the undefeated state championship Division I. We have a coach now, Dale Dunbar, who was a standout at Boston University. He's now probably one of the finest high school hockey coaches in the country, or should we say Massachusetts. And that first year when there was it was so hectic, Patrick Gunn was won the most valuable player in hockey, okay? And I had the great honor of writing about him. Since that time, I think Dale told me a week ago, we've had six most valuable players in the Northeast Conference in hockey. And not only that, Patrick Gunn is one of so many great Winthrop athletes that attained Boston Herald All-Scholastic. So it's my pride, pleasure to introduce Patrick Gunn. His coach in soccer is his presenter, Philip Ronan.
Good evening, everybody. I just want to congratulate all of tonight's inductees and their families and any inductees from the past also. Quite an honor for all of you. And I would be remiss not to mention the hard work of the voice and his committee. What a daunting task it must be for them to sift through the resumes of all the wonderful athletes we've had through the years at Winthrop High School. So thank you very much for your hard work, folks. Patrick Gunn. Unbelievable, unbelievable young man. Three-time hockey all-star in the Northeastern Conference. As Jim alluded to, a most valuable player in the Northeastern Conference in hockey. For me, he is the only Winthrop High School soccer player that has ever led the Northeastern Conference in goals scored. He did that in 2004. In addition, he's the second Winthrop High School soccer player to be elected to the prestigious Eastern Mass All-Star team that is one of the seven best players in the conference. On top of that, he was an excellent, outstanding baseball player. But the thing that impresses me most about him being a former coach is the fact that he is a three-sport captain. When you talk about captain, anybody that's coached in this auditorium knows how invaluable they are and how important they are to team chemistry and assisting us in pushing our program forward in the right direction. Captain is all about character. That's what Patrick Gunn is all about. He's one of the finest young men I've ever coached in my life. Selfless, relentless, fierce competitor, humble, sets the example for his teammates with just hard work, no talk, a credit to his family. Patty and Timmy, great job raising him. Really, really a wonderful young man. I could go on and on about his character, but I'm going to leave you with a couple of quick statements that were made to me by members of this committee. One statement was made about a month and a half ago. I was at a fundraiser with Coach Dunbar, and Coach said to me, he said, Phil, I really, really want to thank you for nominating Patrick. He said, I don't know if you know, but he is one of the greatest, and he emphatically repeated it, one of the greatest hockey players that ever played for Winthrop High School. That's not faint praise coming from Coach Dunbar. We all know the tremendous job he's done with the hockey program, and let's not forget that he did play in the National Hockey League. The second statement that was made to me was made many years ago by my good friend, my former neighbor, and my former principal, Mr. Domenico. As was the norm, Mr. D was across the street on his lounge chair, looking out at the Atlantic Ocean, getting a suntan, and listening to the Sox. And, you know, I was a coach in the system at the time, and many of you folks may not know, Mr. D was the baseball coach a long, long time ago, and you all know him as the tennis coach. And we were just discussing, you know, the specialization of today's athletes, how a lot of athletes have now turned to the year-round participation in one sport. And Mr. D said to me, he said, Phil, he said, let me tell you something. He said, the multi-sport athlete is the lifeblood of a small town like Winthrop's athletic program. The young man that I'm privileged to present to you tonight as the newest member of the Athletic Hall of Fame typifies that multi-sport athlete that is the lifeblood of Winthrop Athletics. It's my distinct pleasure to present Patrick Gunn.
All right, good evening, everyone. First off, thank you, Coach Ronan, for the incredibly kind words. I sincerely mean it. Thank you for believing I was good enough to put forth a nomination on my behalf to the Athletic Hall of Fame Committee. When I received the call that I had been accepted into the WHS Hall of Fame, to say I was caught off guard would be a complete understatement. I am extremely honored and humbled by the committee's decision to elect me into such a distinguished group of outstanding athletes that make up the Hall of Fame. So thank you, Coach. It's much appreciated. I would also like to congratulate all my fellow inductees here with us tonight. It's a privilege and an honor to be sharing this special occasion with you all. Now, for those of you who might know me, my name is Francis Patrick Gunn. For those of you who do not know me, for those of you who do know me, best by Bub or Bubba. I would like to also thank the Winthrop High School Hall of Fame Committee. I'm going to list them out because you guys have done a great job tonight. Peg Bailey, John Domenico, Richard Milano, Richard DeBow, Howard Conley, Dale Dunbar, William Schmidt, Chris Iotis, Rob DiGregorio, and of course, Jim Lederman. So thank you guys. I'd also like to give a special thanks to my friends and family who have continuously supported me throughout my athletic career. For my parents, who have sacrificed many weekends and early mornings for allowing me to follow a passion of mine, whether it was soccer, hockey, or baseball, and helped me excel in these sports that I was and still am and so in love with today. Now that I am a father of two amazing boys, myself, one of which is who's here with us tonight, sorry. As you can tell, I'm a little nervous up here. Landon, he's right over there. Hi, Landon. He has recently embarked on his young athletic journey, and I can truly appreciate and respect all that my parents have done for me. It has not gone unnoticed, and I am forever grateful for all that you've done for me throughout life. You guys have been amazing. I appreciate everything.
I fell in love with athletics at such a young age because I was fueled by the competitiveness of sports and enjoyed being a part of a team. This in turn drove me to want to work extra hard, not only to make myself better, but to help my team be better. Because I've enjoyed the pressure of sports, I've always tried to lead by example. I tried to continue this attitude throughout my career, and by the time I was a senior, I was a three-sport captain in hockey, baseball, and soccer. What my coaches saw in me is what I've always tried to portray as an athlete. Athletics has always been near and dear to my heart, and even to this day, it plays a huge role in my life as I've recently embarked on a new career as a firefighter. With the training I am currently receiving, teamwork is what is stressed the most in order to be successful, much like being a part of a team. So with that being said, these particular sports are considered a team game, and it takes everyone on a team, including the coaches, to produce a Hall of Famer, which is certainly what helped me to get here today. Thank you to all that have contributed to my success as an athlete, which has helped me become the person I am today. And once again, thank you to the committee for this prestigious honor. Thank you.
The next inductee comes from the Winthrop High School class of 1974. During the 70s, Winthrop High School was known as the basketball capital of the North Shore. I think they won 7 Northeast Conference titles in the 70s. And as I've pointed out so many times, basketball is another great tradition in this proud town. 37 Northeast Conference championships in basketball, boys and girls. If you take 6 of the best teams in the Northeast Conference, I don't think their total conference titles equals 20. So this great basketball town has had many great basketball players. So the 74 team, Lou Hinckley was a great player, but let's go back to the 1973 team and one of Winthrop's greatest athletes and greatest basketball players, the gymnasium next door. The basketball court is named for Chris Seotis. He's my teammate, my best friend, my lawyer. His reputation on the North Shore is one of the greatest, okay? But the man who made him great was Lou Hinckley, because he got all the rebounds. Chris Seotis scored 53 points in one game, holds the Northeast Conference title 29 points a game. But Lou Hinckley, not only was he an outstanding athlete in basketball, he was just as great in track, and he broke the record of Arnie Springer, another member of this Hall of Fame. So I'm proud to present a great basketball player, a great athlete, Lou Hinckley from the University of Maine and Winthrop High School. The presenter is Nicholas T. Seotis, a member of the Hall of Fame.
Good evening. Hope everybody's having a great time. And I just seen so many great athletes who have come by, and there's just so many great stories in this room, like Chuck Flanagan when he became the agent for Paul Gallivan when he went down to kick for the New Orleans Saints. And I just want to say that the year I graduated a couple years before Lou Hinckley, and that year when Lou played in 1973, Winthrop was not small. They had the biggest front line in history. I've watched, announced Winthrop basketball. I've been around it 50 years. That particular year, they had Chris Seotis at center at 6'5", Lou at 6'4", played at UMaine, Mike Welch, great player, University of Pennsylvania, Eddie Ducky Quinn, all over 6'3", 6'4". Backcourt was Mike Harrison, along with Steve Mahoney, 6'1", 6'2", and they had George Calajeros, who played 4 years at Suffolk University. That was quite a team. It was a golden era. Lou Hinckley is from a distinguished Winthrop family that has made contributions to this town, especially his mother, Margaret, who was a fixture at the Winthrop Public Library for decades. Lou was a quiet and humble leader as a basketball captain. He inspired others with his work ethic and with his indomitable competitive spirit. He exuded confidence, and he transmitted that quality to all of his teammates. Because of his tremendous ability, as Bob Flanagan said, to elevate over the rim, he was dubbed Lou Leaper. He was part of a Viking theatrical cast, including Joe Jama, Chris Kramer, Steve Stuffer, and Hub Hanger. Lou was a great shooter, rebounder, and he served dinner to opponents as a tremendous shot blocker. His teams would win two Northeastern Conference titles and go to the Division II state final at the Boston Garden, where they played a team that was a Division I team, believe it or not, that would combine that, yeah, Cambridge Ridge and Latin and Ridge Tech, and move down. Very controversial game, one-point game. During his tenure here under Coach Henry McCarthy, Lou would win 35 games and lose only six. I have to allude to one story about his leaping. We had just got through playing the illustrious game known as DFA ball that Coach Robert DeFelice started. Four games of 21, no fouls. Mike Ruggioni was quite a player as well. And we had ended the game, so we decided to have a leaping contest between Kevin Dowd, who was playing at for Jim Luskethoff at Boston State, and Lou Hinckley. So they both got a piece of adhesive tape, white adhesive tape, and they ran in from the key, and they would go to the left side of the rim. One would put it on, next one put it on. Before we know it, the tape was on the square. By the time it was over, the tape was, they both jumped close to 2 feet over the top of the square, just putting that white adhesive tape up there. Lou would go on to play at the University of Maine, where he competed in basketball and track and field. The springtime, he was also playing basketball with us in the league in Winthrop, so there were a lot of times he didn't go to practice, but he set a Yankee conference record, high jumping, 6'10". To watch Lou clearing the bar in the high jump, going over backwards, a la Fosbury flop, was breathtaking. When Lou high jumped, he had the perfect technique of a great artist. He was poetry in motion and in midair. If this had been the ancient Olympic Games, Lou would have been depicted on a Grecian urn. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present my lifelong friend on this day of his induction into the Winthrop High School Athletic Hall of Fame, Lou Hinckley.
Thanks for that great introduction, Nick. It's extremely humbling and amazing to me to be here tonight. First of all, I want to thank the members of the Hall of Fame committee, and especially those on it who could actually remember me from my high school days back in the early 1970s. I've always been very thankful for the privilege of growing up in the town of Winthrop and attending the school system there. I'm especially thankful for the great teachers and coaches that I was able to work with, from Coach Gorman in the eighth grade, to Coaches DiGregorio and McDonald in the ninth grade, to Coaches Nimblett, Dyer, McGee, and McCarthy as an upperclassman. All of these teachers slash coaches not only taught us the skills we needed to succeed in competition, but they also provided wonderful role models that helped to shape our lives as we went on to college and beyond. The values and principles that they conveyed on us stayed with us well beyond our high school days. For that, so many of us will always be thankful. I'd also like to thank John Domenico, Jim Lederman, Bill Schmidt, Nick and Chris Ciotis, Bob DeGregorio, Steve Mahoney, Adam Hubley, Joe Frank, Mike and Sally Shirley, and all of my teammates and friends over the years who've always been there for me. And finally, I'd like to thank my very best friend and wife, Lee, and our amazing daughter, Lydia. Thank you all very much.
The next inductee from the Winthrop High School, class of 1998. What we've talked about tonight are great families, great tradition. Joey Murray comes from a family with three boys, became captain of Winthrop High School football teams, all great teams, coached by Coach Tony Fusillo. Talk about great families, that's the tradition of this great town. When Joey Murray was playing in high school, he was one of the most feared running backs in the Northeast Conference. I went to watch him play two games in college. Colby College had two of the greatest football players in Winthrop High School history, Mark D'Ambrosio and Joey Murray. I watched them win their league title. It was a great thrill. Two super athletes and super football captains. Joey Murray not only was a great athlete, but a great two-sport athlete at Winthrop High School. Winthrop touchdown, scored by number 22, Joey the Jet Murray. The presenter is Mark D'Ambrosio.
Thank you, Jim. I've got a small sheet here, so we should be good. First off, thank you to the Hall of Fame committee. This is an amazing night that you all put together, and I know it means a lot to all of the inductees and all of their families and friends. Congratulations to all of the tonight's inductees, the individuals, and the teams. I was a teammate of Paul's, and I think that everything that Rob said about Paul as a captain and as a leader was spot on. And I was on the field for that hit versus Mark Silvestri, and it's the best hit I've ever seen when you put into consideration the pomp and circumstance of Thanksgiving, the guy that he put it on, and it was in the middle of a streak from Paul's halftime of his junior year till 4.5 years later before Winthrop scored on Revere. So I think we shut him out for 14 quarters, Coach. Was that about right? So congratulations to everybody. Yes, very much when you talk about Joe Murray, you talk about family. I had the good fortune of being coached by Joe's father, Dennis Murray. The type of person that he was, I played soccer for Mr. Murray, and he picked me up one time when I had to do my paper route and I was running late, and he took me from house to house to deliver newspapers, bought me breakfast, and took me to the game. And those are the type of coaches that there are in this town that make the players that play for them want to give back, and he was definitely that type of person. Gina Murray is just the warmest, nicest person that you could ever meet. When you went into their home when we were younger, it was just you know, very Norman Rockefeller scene. You know, it all started with her at the center of it all, her and her boys. Joey was one of three Murray football captains. And when they redid the locker room a few years ago, there was a plaque and it said Band of Brothers. And it was Dennis and Joseph and Matthew who were all captains. Dennis, I will always remember in 1993, Winthrop was playing Beverly. Beverly was the highly favored best team in the conference. And we went to Beverly and beat them 14-6. At one point they had scored and it was 7-6 and they were gonna kick the extra point. And Dennis blocked the kick, and that was an amazing picture and an amazing play, excuse me, for a Super Bowl team. And Matthew is also getting inducted tonight, so this is absolutely hands down Gina Murray's night. I mean, right? So, I mean, she's going to explode. So, you know, you know, so congratulations to Matthew. Joey, I may be biased. You know, I think the best Murray football player. As a freshman, he broke his wrist, so we didn't really know what he was going to do. He's an amazing soccer player in youth soccer. But his sophomore year, in his first start, he scored a touchdown. I remember that. There was an older kid that was the starting three back over him who never got his job back. Our junior year, we went down to Hull, and Hull was a team that eventually made the Super Bowl. And we were down early, and at the end, we gave the ball to Joey around the end. He scored the game-winning touchdown in the article in the Boston Herald that next morning was Murray Hurries for Winthrop Win. And that year, you know, we had a great team, and we're 9-2, and Joey was a huge part of that. Had two interceptions at Swampscott against Peter Bush, which was another Super Bowl team that we went on the road and came up victorious versus. So Joey had some great games. When you talk about Joey as a Hall of Famer, his senior year is one of the great individual seasons for any Winthrop athlete. He had 110 points in a season. He was the Northeastern Conference MVP. He was the Lynn Item Offensive Player of the Year. He was an Aganis All-Star. He was a Shriner. He was All-State, which goes to, you know, only 22 players in the entire state. There's been a lot of All-Scholastics and that have come through Winthrop, but I don't know how many All-States. I'm sure Jim would know, but, you know, that was a great honor to Joe. He was a great student-athlete, National Football Foundation Hall of Fame member as a senior, so as all the Murrays were. The one thing that I would say is if you had the good fortune of playing high school sports and college sports, high school sports with the town and the people that you grew up with, you have a certain bond. The kids that you play t-ball with are the guys that you play football with when you graduate. And then you go to college, and it's a different experience because now you don't go home after the game. You go back to your dorm room, and you're with those people 24/7. I had the special experience of being a college teammate of Joe's as well. I was in the coach's offices showing them the tape of this kid scoring 110 points, and it wasn't a very hard sell to get him there. And my senior year, there were actually three starters from Winthrop on that team, Matt Mahoney being the third. So you got three kids from this small community out of 22 on a team that won the conference championship that year. In Joe's final game, Kristen, I'm sorry, at Bowdoin, he rushed for 100 yards in a victory of Colby over Bowdoin, and that shows the type of player that Joe was. As great a football player, a better friend, and an amazing person, I think the best testament to his father and the type of family that the Murrays are is the father that Joe is today, with his wonderful wife, Zoraida, and Max and Maya, who are in the stands. If any of you are ever down Ingleside Park at about 4 or 5 o'clock on a weeknight, you'll see Joey coming down, and he's got his red wagon, and he's pulling his two kids, and he takes them to the park back and forth. And I just think that's amazing. And, you know, he's just an amazing dad. So congratulations, Joe.
Hey, buddy. Good evening, everyone. Thanks, Mark, for that great introduction. You're always a tough act to follow, but I couldn't have said it better myself. Thanks, buddy. First off, I'd like to thank the Hall of Fame committee for hosting this great night to honor all of us washed-up has-beens and high school heroes. But seriously, I'd like to congratulate all my fellow inductees. I know how much hard work and dedication you all put into becoming the best student-athletes you could in high school and beyond. I'm sure this night is special for all of us in many different ways, but for me, it's important because I get to share it with my wife, Zoraida, my son, Max, and my daughter, Maya, who have never really seen me play sports, so this is a nice way for me to show them how big of a part sports in my life for a very long time. And now, as my kids are beginning to get involved in organized sports, it makes me think how great participating sports can be for kids. It teaches us so many great lessons that we can take with us throughout our lives. Teamwork, camaraderie, hard work, dedication, working to achieve goals, and most importantly, the joy of winning and the pain of losing. I hope I can help my kids garner all of the positive experiences that I receive from sports the same way my parents did for me. My mother and father are here supporting me tonight like they did when I just started out as a little kid and as they've done in everything I've done in my whole entire life. T-ball, soccer, basketball, baseball, football, my parents were there coaching me or cheering me on every step of the way. They never missed anything I did. Sacrificing their time and energy for me and my brothers, always teaching us how to play, and more importantly, the right way to compete. Always stressing to work hard, be humble, and without ever putting any pressure on us, how to play or perform in any way. One thing they did stress, though, in everything we did, was that whatever we did, we should try to be the best at it. Always try to win, whether it was sports, school, or even the Pinewood Derby. Being the best and winning was always the goal. But if we didn't win, there was only love and support from them. Never disappointment. They always made participating in sports enjoyable and fulfilling. Growing up and playing sports in Winthrop was amazing for me. I'm very lucky to have a great group of friends that came together as young kids and remain that way up until now. Some of my best memories playing sports was with them in the backfields and intersections of Winthrop, playing football, stickball, street hockey, and basketball, always challenging each other. We rose up together through all the town sports, sometimes as teammates, but most of the time as opponents, up until high school, where we were able to come together. Competing together, we could always depend on each other. We always had each other's backs, and we were always rooting for each other to succeed. Even now, they all wanted to come here tonight to help me celebrate this great event. Thanks, guys. Coming up through high school, we were lucky to have so many great examples to follow. My freshman year, my brother Dennis was there to look up as someone who led by example and always did things the right way. My sophomore year, my fellow inductee Paul Ferrara, who I've known my entire life, was such a big influence on me. He was the ultimate leader, always, and he also played the same position as me. He's the epitome of the saying, walk quietly and carry a big stick. He didn't say a lot, but when he did, everyone listened. My junior year, I was able to play alongside a lot of great guys, especially Mark D'Ambrosia. During this time, Mark was very important to my success on and off the football field. Not only is he a natural leader who always rises up above the group, he's an amazing motivator, always pushing everyone to be better with positivity, support, and high energy. We were always workout partners, pushing each other to do one more rep, one more sprint, forcing each other to get better. And we always had a friendly competition with everything we did. When we played football together in college, we always had preseason testing. And Mark and I would run our own 40-yard dashes, but always we'd end the testing with a timed race against each other in front of the whole team. We were always neck and neck, alternating wins, but at times were always the fastest when we raced each other. Neither one of us ever wanted to lose. Thank you, Mark, for always pushing me and supporting me. Our senior year, we were able to exceed all expectations because we played together like brothers. We were always outsized, but we never played like it. We relished the idea of beating up on the biggest schools. It was great to play alongside guys with tremendous talent and even bigger hearts, like Mike Ferrara, Ronaldo Agostinelli, Bubba Pisano, Derek Armistead, Mike Phillips, Mike Beattie, and Jamie Wilson. We were always very fortunate to have an amazing group of coaches led by Tony Fusillo. Coach Fusillo always expected and demanded a great deal of commitment and dedication and never allowed any nonsense. He cared about all of us and wanted us all to be successful student athletes and, more importantly, good people. We were usually outsized on the football field, but he never let us use that as an excuse and made us believe we could beat anybody anytime by outworking them and being together and being tougher than them. Coach Vinny Arizioni and Jimmy Gillis were also a big part of my development as my position coaches and my baseball coaches, and they always made it fun and loose. Growing, and now after high school, it was great for me to watch my younger brother, Matthew, come up through the school and enjoy so much success in everything he does. Matthew is an amazing man who excels in everything he does and makes it look effortless. But I know how hard he works at the things that are important to him, and I'm very proud of you. And it's great that I can share this night with him tonight and the rest of his team that got inducted here tonight for their accomplishments as well. Congratulations. So thank you again to the committee. This means a great deal to me. Thank you. Good night.
Good evening. I have the pleasure and honor of introducing a coach I've known for a very long time. Who knew we'd still be playing softball on June 15th, 1984? The Lady Vikings were Northeast Conference champs that year and went on to win the state title, defeating Bishop Fenwick along the way. Not an easy thing to do. I am grateful to have been a part of it all. I was the team manager. The Lady Vikings, coached by Ron Spinney and Bill Gorman, were 17-3 during the regular season, winning 14 of their last 15 games, the MIAA tournament in single elimination, and the Lady Vikings won three more games to become state champions, defeating East Longmeadow by a score of 3-0 in the final at Whitensville. Mr. Spinney wrote a poem about this team entitled, "Where is Whitensville?" Ladies and gentlemen, I am honored and blessed to be the person to present Mr. Ron Spinney, the head coach of the 1984 state champion softball team, for induction to the Hall of Fame.
Good evening. I would like to thank the selection committee, first for selecting the 1984 state champion softball team for induction into the Hall of Fame, and second for postponing this induction until this evening so that I could attend. This was supposed to be inducted 2 years ago, but I could not make it. I would like to congratulate our fellow inductees on being recognized for the contributions you have made to make the athletic history of Winthrop High School one that we and the town can be proud of. On the way over here tonight, my daughter Leslie asked me what I remembered from the season of 1984. Little did she know that that becomes, at my age, a tricky and difficult question. I gave it some thought. I remember Ruth and Artie Alexander. Before Viking Pride supplied buses for Winthrop High School athletic teams, they drove our teams all over the North Shore and finally to Whitensville. My only wish was that we had GPS in those days, as they had some very creative routes to our games. Both Ruth and Artie became a big part of our Viking family. I remember Jim Evans, our AD, who blazed the trail for equality of programs and who was largely responsible for the success of the girls' athletic program in the 70s, 80s, and 90s. I will never forget Jim out there in the rain, spreading quick dry all over the infield so we could finish the game. Suffolk Downs wasn't the only place to have mutters. I remember cowbells ringing in the stands every time we did something positive. The noise happily supplied by our two most loyal fans, Jerry Gillis and Phyllis Fluitt. I'm sure Ruth and Artie would be happy to give Phyllis a ride to our next game. And if there is room on the bus, they can stop to pick up a gentleman who devoted his whole life to the town of Winthrop as an educator, a coach, and as an administrator. His calm demeanor, his knowledge of the game, and his leadership were instrumental to our success. The town thought so much of him, they named a school after him. I remember Bill Gorman. I remember a woman who has given over 40 years of her life to Winthrop High School athletics, who has been a friend and a confidant to hundreds of athletes, and who was my right hand in the 59 seasons we worked together. Whether driving a van, keeping score, consoling bruised egos, she was always there when I needed her. I remember Peg, call me Shaggy or Pegster, Bailey. I remember June 9th, 1984, a warm spring day, playing the best team on the North Shore, Bishop Fenwick. They had beaten us in the Division II North Finals 2-1 the year before by scoring the run in the last of the seventh inning on a short, wild pitch. And now here we were, tied 2-2 in the top of the seventh. The coach asked a young player to take her first at-bat of the year to lead off the seventh inning. I remember Tina Wood lining a base hit to left field. Two batters later, we had a runner on first and third with one out, and a shallow fly ball was hit to left field. The coach foolishly sent the runner. The ball easily beat her to home plate. But long before Dave Roberts made his famous slide, I remember Debbie McManus sliding into the catcher and knocking the ball loose for a 3-2 lead. I remember our center fielder racing into right center for the final out of the game, a feat she would duplicate a week later in the state championship game. Long before athletes were known by their first name, like Larry and Michael, or by their initials, such as DJ, our center fielder was known to everyone and the town of Winthrop simply as T. I remember Teeny Bruce. I remember a right field combination of Diane Musi, Joanne Rodriguez, who together gave us what we needed in right field. A left fielder who batted cleanup and made all the catches that came her way. I remember as a young lad going down to watch her father knock the ball out of Veterans Field in the town softball league. And now here she was knocking the ball around the little league field for me. I remember Sharon Farley. I remember a tough bundle of energy at third base, a hockey goalie in the winter, enough said, who knocked down everything that came her way, sometimes the base runners. I remember Gina Pomati. I remember a sure-handed shortstop who caught most every ball hit her way and who was the glue that kept our infield together. I remember Susan Hodgkins. I remember a second baseman who wanted so badly to play the game of softball that she had an elastic put around her thumb and taped to her wrist so that she could hold a bat and throw a ball. That determination and fine play not only led her to the Winthrop High School Hall of Fame and a four-year career at BC, but now she is the superintendent of the Winthrop School System. I remember Lisa Gill. I remember a fine fielding first baseman who was the best hitter I ever coached, who led our team in RBIs, and who seemed to get a big hit every time when it counted. I remember Lisa Stanovitz. In 1962, the Yankees had the M&M boys, Mantle and Maris. We had the M&M battery. I remember a catcher who had the job of catching a pitcher who was not always in the same area code as the home plate. She did a great job and had an excellent arm as well. I remember Leanne Mirabella. And I remember that pitcher who in the tournament in five games gave up 12 hits and four runs and threw three shutouts. She was the fiercest competitor I ever coached and is arguably one of the best female athletes in Winthrop High School history. I remember Lisa Monteleone. But what stands out in my failing memory is a young lady who did not play in the first 10 games of the season, but who in the last 10 games had two winning doubles, which propelled us to the league championship, and in the state championship game, a two-run single in the seventh inning that clinched it for us. I remember Janine Gettig. These players, along with Chris DeFelice, Debbie Spencer, and Paula Cavalieri, made up the team that I remember, a team that is the only female state champion in over 100 years of Winthrop High School athletics. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the 1984 state champion softball team. Please stand, ladies.
The second team that we're going to honor tonight not only distinguished themselves as one of three Winthrop teams to win Super Bowls. They can't say that in Swampscott. They can't say that in Marblehead. We have three Super Bowl championship teams. The 2006 football team gave me some of the greatest memories of my life, and it's an honor I've had to broadcast this particular team. Not only were they 13-0, they finished second in Eastern Mass to that powerhouse called Everett University. The second best team in Eastern Massachusetts, coached by Tony Fusillo. It had three all-scholastic players on that team. Joey Murray, two-time all-scholastic. James Fusillo, all-scholastic. Most valuable player in the Northeast Conference, and a big guy at center, I think his name was Robert Hamilton. Three all-scholastics from one team. I don't know if they can say that in Swampscott. But what I remember most, it was 2 years after Viking Pride was started, and this team went undefeated in the Northeast Conference and captured the Super Bowl at Stonehill College before a capacity crowd. Number three, Super Bowl for Winthrop, and the two coaches are here tonight, Bobby DeFelice and Tony Fusillo. Great coaches, great athletes. But what I remember most of all was a Saturday afternoon at Stonehill College before a big capacity crowd. As they come back up the field, the final score from Stonehill College, Winthrop 25, Wareham 8. They are Super Bowl champions, and here's their coach, Tony Fusillo.
Thank you, Jim. First of all, I'd like the 2006 state champion Super Bowl team to please come up and stand up. Please come up here. I'd like to congratulate all the inductees tonight into the Winthrop High School Football Hall of Fame. This is certainly a well-deserved and most meaningful award, and you deserve all of it. I want to thank the Hall of Fame committee for this great night. I know the hard work that goes into an evening like this. It is certainly my honor tonight as coach to induct the 2006 Super Bowl and state champion football team. And I want to emphasize team into the Hall of Fame. And I know there will always be a debate as to what was the greatest football team to play at Winthrop High School. And I'll leave it up to coffee shop talk and sports writers and sports reporters to decide. The 2006 Winthrop High School Super Bowl team won 13 games and finished with an undefeated season. Offensively, they scored 500 points. They averaged 38 points a game. As an offensive team, they rushed for 3,754 yards and passed for over 1,000. And defensively, they only gave up 6 points per game. In the first quarter alone, they outscored their opponents 162-0. Talk about being ready to play, focused, and with attention to detail. These are all Winthrop High School records. And most importantly, this senior group beat Revere 4 straight times. As I look back on the season, I often thought of what were the traits and intangibles that made this team a Super Bowl champion. Number one, they were competitors. They had a competitive heart and they had a passion for winning. This foundation did not just happen in high school. It was forged in youth football under the great coach, Phil Hamilton. Phil, are you here tonight? Please stand up. And under Paul Smith, who is responsible for building youth football program to where it is today. Paul Smith, will you please stand up? But this 2006 football team had one great trait. They loved to win and hated to lose. And let me repeat that. These guys loved to win and they hated to lose. They had one common goal and they sacrificed 100% for team goals. Everyone willing to sacrifice for the good of the team. It was whatever it took. They had great trust in each other, both on and off the field. And in short, they had each other's back. They had a chemistry which were built on bonds. Working together, they were able to handle any adversity and they became stronger. They had exceptional senior leadership. They never cut corners. They had effort, attitude, and toughness. Actions always spoke louder than words. They were consistent. They knew how to practice. They developed a machine-like mentality, focused on being excellent in every rep, every drill, every day. And finally, they had an amazing coaching staff consisting of James Gillis, Richard Fusillo, Sean Driscoll, Dave Guffey, John Cadigan, an amazing trainer, and Scott Hogan. But the real head coach of the Vikings couldn't be here tonight. He's in Las Vegas, gambling. Frankie Fabiano called me and made sure that I would mention him tonight. And I would also like to thank the administration at Winthrop High School during my time, and especially Principal Gail Conlon, for administrative support during this magical football season. So tonight, with Viking pride, it is my honor to present to you the 2006 Super Bowl and state champion football team. You know, I would like, though, for each one of them to come up here and just say their name and introduce themselves. Come on, guys. You deserve it. Come on. Thanks,
Coach. Phil Hamilton, senior on the team, captain. We couldn't have done it without Coach Fusillo, all the other coaches. All right. Thank you.
Rob Hamilton, junior on the team, center. Thank you, Coach Fusillo.
Joe McDermott, junior on the team, running back.
Frank Ambrosino, freshman, running back on the team.
Vinny Ruzioni, junior, wide receiver on the team.
Matt Murray, captain on the team, and just wanted to say thanks to all my teammates and all the coaches.
Kyle D. Cadet, junior on the team, and thank you to the committee and all my coaches for everything.
Kevin Harris, number 67 of the strongest side of the offensive line.
Dan Shannon, I was a sophomore on the team.
Mark Shannon, tight end, senior. Thank you.
James Fusillo, senior quarterback.
Andrew Souza, the biggest tackle on the team.
Adam Peroni, junior linebacker.
Marcus Checa, freshman, tight end.
Dave Fry, senior on the team.
Robert Deeb, freshman, wide receiver, D-back.
James Daugherty, freshman, linebacker.
I was Jason Griffin, number 22, running back and D-back, senior. Thank you.
Great team, great players, Super Bowl champions. I forgot to acknowledge my boss, Kerry Schumann from the Winthrop Transcript, who's covered all these Super Championship teams. And to everyone here tonight, it's been a fantastic night. I hope you all enjoyed it. We're going to celebrate at JW's restaurant. We have reservations for the greatest class and the greatest Hall of Fame inductees. Have a great night. Thank you. Mm-hmm.